My understanding is the president always wanted to meet with Putin in America first. He didn't want to go to Moscow first. He didn't want a third country first. He didn't want their first meeting to be on the sidelines of some other engagement. And so he agreed to Helsinki, but now he's back to his original plan, which is the first meeting with Putin in his home turf, in the United States, in Trump's home turf. And I think that's what this is about. I don't have any, no one's been tougher on Putin and on interference than I've been, I believe. That said, I don't have a problem with the president of the United States interacting with the president of the Russian Federation. They've got a lot of nuclear weapons, and so we do need to interact with them. That is separate from the question of whether or not in those interactions we should be clear-eyed about who Putin is. He's not interested in better relations with the United States. I think he walked away from that a long time ago. He's interested in gaining advantage at our expense and to his benefit. And as long as we go in with a very clear understanding, we can engage him all we want, but not under any illusions.
You have suggested in the past that you think Putin might be responsible for war crimes, not just in Syria.
No, he has been. I know he has.
Okay. Do you have a problem with him coming to the White House? I mean, meeting with the president is one thing, but coming to the White House is another.
Well, I don't. I mean, the symbolism of it, I think people could make the argument you've just pointed out. There is no doubt in my mind that Putin has authorized war crimes. He also possesses, between us, 90% of the world's nuclear weapons. The president pointed it out this week. So it's kind of one of those tough situations where he's, you know, if he was a dictator of a third world country, we would treat him one way. Unfortunately, geopolitical reality means we have to engage with a guy like this. But knowing exactly who he is, this is the guy that shot down that Malaysian airliner. This is the guy that invaded Ukraine. This is the guy that took Crimea. This is the guy that murders his political opponents. This is who we're dealing with. And this is the guy that bombs aid convoys in Syria and helps the Syrian regime gas people by covering for him at the United Nations. This is who we are dealing with. Well, as long as we know that, you know.